Hello YouTube! So today I am back with another video. I know it's been a while. I'm sorry. You know, I thought last year was gonna be the year that I would be recording and making videos and uploading, and I made one video and then one vlog and then that was it. So here I am again. I am trying to be really good about posting my projects and things like that, especially since I am getting married this year. Hello. So since I'm getting married this year, I have a lot of DIY projects that I want to do. So my bridal shower is coming up, and also obviously the wedding is coming up. So I really want to share with you guys kind of the DIYs that I've been working on. So there's actually a lot of things that I've been recording, but it's just I haven't been putting it together into videos. So today I'm going to share with you my first DIY video that I have put up in a while. And okay, let's just dive right in. I feel kind of nervous, but Brian will edit this and it'll be great. So the DIY that I'm sharing today is actually a DIY frame, and it is something that I made out of a larger picture frame that I found at Michael's. We're using it today as a part of my parents' nail salon, actually, so they kind of renovated the whole thing, and I thought it was time to finally upgrade the price list. If I can, I'll insert the picture right here. Let's begin. So I gave my paint a good shake, and here I'm using the Martha Stewart chalkboard paint in the black color. I just found it to be really opaque. I also got this at Michael's and it was really affordable. So as you can see here, I'm directly putting the paint onto the actual board, and I just found this to be the easiest method, especially since you're not actually having to mix any paints. Since we are just going in with this black chalkboard paint, it's totally fine to just squeeze it onto the board and then just lightly and gently roll it around. I found that having a light pressure was the best way to go about this to get an even, smooth texture across the whole board. I would suggest to roll in an up and down motion, and then after you go one way, you want to go the other way. So once you're done going horizontally, you want to go vertically and make sure that there are no visible streaks, especially when it comes to the chalkboard paint, because you really want it to be one cohesive flat surface that you get your chalk on.
12 seconds later.
So in between coats, I let it dry, and then I came back, put on more paint, and then just worked my way from the top to the bottom of that whole entire board. So I found it really helpful here to make sure that everything is really, really even and smooth. So take your time and roll it back and forth. I gave this actually about 3 coats before I thought it was perfect. Depending on what paint you use, it could take less or it could take more. So depending on the paint that you're using, you want to make sure that you have enough drying time before you actually start priming it. So this paint in particular, you need 24 hours before it cures, so I came back to the project the next day. And here you can see I popped that board back into the frame, and then I went over the whole thing with chalk to make sure that I primed the whole surface before using it. But depending on the sign that you're using, you just want to make sure that you have even spacing throughout. Here you can see I just have 1-inch lines in between each one, and I made sure that I had enough spacing between how many lines I needed for this menu. So I figured out how many lines I needed by typing everything out onto a Word document. Just counting out how many lines that I had and how much surface I had to work with, I just kind of did some quick math and spaced it out correctly and evenly throughout the whole board. So for the actual writing on the board, you want to use chalkboard marker, and the one that I'm using is actually just called a Bistro chalk marker, and I've got that also at Michael's. There's many brands out there that you can use. I found that this one is really great because it comes in a variety of tips. So there's a chiseled one, there's round ones. For this particular project, I'm using a round tipped marker. So for the finishing touch, I actually put a vinyl decal onto this chalkboard wall in white, and I just thought that this just kind of gave it a really clean, nice professional look, especially for the sign. I wanted something that is a little bit more fun with the personal touches with the handwriting, but also a little bit more professional since it is for a nail salon. You kind of can see here, I just keep moving it back and forth before I kind of had the placement perfectly straight and correct. I even used my laser level 50 times before I actually got it down. And what you can do if you don't have a laser level is actually use the chalk and use that as guidelines, which I find to be super helpful. Measuring out the top of the decal, the bottom, and then the middle, and then making sure that everything just looks even and straight. So this sign is really easy to make, and I think it's really nice to have a personal touch, especially when it comes to something like your wedding or a small business. Just having that handwritten look really gives it that personal touch. But I'm really happy with how this came out, and I think it looks awesome. I think anyone could do this, and if you have, you know, 2 days to set aside to do this project, you can totally nail it. Okay, so that's the end. I feel like my voice changes when I'm like instructing someone and then talking regularly. So I hope that you found this video to be super helpful in creating a chalkboard sign. And if you have any questions, leave it down in the comments and I'd be more than happy to help. I find that this is a really simple process and really therapeutic. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I'm really excited to start posting regularly. Woohoo! So I am planning to post on Wednesdays and Sundays. So watch out for my next video coming out on Sunday. I'm planning to share more things like wedding DIYs as well as bullet journaling and other DIYs that I come out with. And also, me and Brian actually have a channel. If you don't know who Brian is, my fiance, soon to be husband. Brian and I actually have a joint channel now. It's called Life of the Max. And on that channel, that's where we're really sharing our personal lives. So we're gonna be talking about wedding planning, getting married, relationship things, as well as just life things. So if you wanna check that out, I'll link that down below as well. All right, guys, so now we're at the end. I'm just going to close this. I don't really know how to close this, but I will say goodbye and I'll see you on Sunday. Bye. Sorry for being awkward. I know that you're gonna edit this, Brian. You're just gonna be cringing.